Hey guys, welcome back to Auto Repair Guys. Thank you guys for watching and subscribing to the channel. In today's video guys, we'll be working on a Chevy Cruze guys, and we'll show you how to remove or how to replace CV axle drive shaft. We'll demonstrate on the passenger side, but the driver side is should be exactly the same. Quick introduction guys, we'll have more than 200 videos on Chevy Cruze and more than 200 videos on every car we get at the shop. Why? Because our mission here at the shop guys is to save you as much money as we can. So please guys, subscribe to our channel and like the video. Hopefully you will find the information helpful. Now, if you guys want to save even more money, check out the link in the description of the video below and you can see where you can buy the parts for a really good price and fast shipping as well. So let's start on it now. So whether you're working on the right side or the front right or front left, procedure is practically the same guys. So what we need to do, we need to remove, you have a wheel hubs, okay, covers, wheel covers, go ahead, remove them. You get those plastic nuts loose, remove it. If you have aluminum wheels, you just skip to that step. Right now we're going to get the lug nuts loose, okay. We'll have to go ahead and pull the emergency brake guys. Have the car in park, if it's automatic, manual, okay, put in first or reverse. Usually consult your manual how to do that, but you can use guys the artichokes. They're the devices that you put behind the rear tire so the car doesn't roll anywhere on you. So we're going to get those loose, okay. While we're doing that actually, okay, let me show you what a tire choke means. And okay, we have here. That's it. That's guys the device I'm talking about. You just put it behind your tires. Okay, and what's going to happen? You should put two of those, one on the front, one on the rear side of the tire. And when you place them, the car cannot roll on you. So I recommend to have four of these, two on each rear tires when you're working on the front end of your car. Do that only on level ground. Don't do it guys on a slope, because it can easily fall off the jack or the jack stand. So we're going to jack it up now and we'll get a jack stand. Always use that jack stands, otherwise what could happen guys, if that jack fails, the car will fall on you. So if you're super lucky, you might survive. You may get hurt, you may get killed if you're unlucky. It really depends guys, but you have to be extremely careful and always think twice when you do that stuff. Okay, so we can see we're lifting it up now, coming off the ground. Okay, now we're going to install the jack stand. Perfect, make sure that it's good. Now what we'll do, we'll just remove the lug nuts all the way. First we just got them barely loose to where they can go by hand. Then we'll remove the wheel and we'll get to the suspension. Okay, we're almost there. Perfect. Now we're going to take the wheel off, guys. Okay, pretty heavy wheel. And what we're going to do, we'll actually put it under the car. Okay, just in case if something goes wrong, if it falls, at least it will fall on the wheel. So once you guys remove the wheel, in order to remove the CV axle, now we'll demonstrate on the right side, but the front left will be about the same guys. You need to find a socket, okay, that fits your nut. I think it's a 32 millimeter. We're using 1 inch and one corner. It fits really good as well, so that works great. Now if you guys do not have air compressor or impact, you can guys have a breaker bar, one person to hold the brake inside, and you're going to get that nut loose. But since we have that little bitty air compressor, which is amazing guys, we'll have the link in the description of the video below, that thing pumps all the way to 165, even to 170 psi, and it can even operate an impact guys. It's amazing and makes things so much easier. So we'll go ahead and take that nut off now. Okay, perfect. Check it out. It just came out in no time, guys. So that makes things way easier. Now, what I'll recommend, okay, if yours is really old, you live in a climate where you have more rain, snow, you may develop rust here. So you may use, guys, penetrating spray, okay, to spray a little bit. So inside where the CV axle and the wheel hub, guys, contact, will break that rust loose and everything will come out easier. Otherwise, guys, okay, otherwise it could be a big mess. Sometimes they get stuck. So what we use Interphone, guys, this is amazing spray, a little bit expensive, but this is a great penetrating spray that we've been using here now. And you just spray, let it sit for 5-10 minutes while you're working on something else. So now we need to disconnect the bottom ball joint, the one that where the control arm connects to the spindle, and we'll do that and then we'll continue. Okay, let me explain what you need to do right here on the bottom, guys. Okay, let me just focus quick, give me a second. Okay, still a little bit blurry. Okay, perfect. That bolt now, guys, okay, right there, that nut will need to be removed. This is the one that holds the control arm on the bottom towards the wheel hub. And we have the same, okay, let me get it from this side now. Okay, on this side is a bolt, on the other side is a nut. So I'm going to hold it here with one wrench while another person is taking it loose on the other side. Okay, and we need to take the bolt, the nut all the way off, and we'll need to slide the bolt out. So let's pass the little impact now. Okay, probably save us a little bit of time. Okay, perfect. You can see working that way. Now we need to, guys, we actually probably, okay, let me try, see if I can unscrew it from this side with the 15 millimeter, or we'll need to. No, it's spinning freely, guys. What do we have to do? Put the nut on the other side a little bit on, so we don't make mess up the screw. And we are going to tap on it, guys, okay, with the hammer, until it starts coming out, and then we'll take the nut off. So, you have to be extremely careful, because if you bent it, okay, the thread, you won't be able to reuse it. So bolt is out. So we get a pry bar now, guys. Okay, let me explain right there. We're going to pry, okay, to separate, okay, the hub from the control arm. Okay, that's the ball joint, the bottom ball joint, right there, guys. So just a little bit more and we'll be out. Okay, perfect. It came out, and you can see now the hub is not attached to the control arm anymore, guys. So we can gently pull it out. Careful not to break your ABS cable in the way. So now we'll need to go ahead, guys, and turn the steering wheel all the way to the right. Since we're on the right side, that way it will open that way a little bit and we'll have more room to work with. Check it out now. So we should be able to get that CV axle out. More. Okay, perfect. Now that should definitely give us a little bit more room. What I'll recommend, guys, okay, never ever hammer on the axle itself, because you can damage it. You can use an extension, punch, something, guys, okay, to tap on it. Or if you need to hammer, put the nut. And every time you replace it, guys, it's recommended to put a new locking nut as well. You can see this one here. So, we're going to gently, guys, okay, push it out. You can see how it started moving. This is great. What I'll do, I'll pull the hub a little bit this way, while one person, okay, is trying to pull to push it out. Okay, almost came out on the back side. Just pull the hub a little bit. Okay, a little bit stuck. Okay, let me see. Now it's just on the thread there, but okay, this is one long CV axle, guys. So most of the times they come out like that with no problem. Okay, but this one is way longer than I thought. In some cases, you may need to remove, to disconnect the steering ball joint, the tie rod. So we'll actually go ahead. Okay, turn the steering wheel a little bit to the right. To the left. Okay, and it came out because we were too much to the right. So you can see it came out. We don't need to disconnect the tie rod, guys. That's how you guys do it. So we just needed to turn the steering wheel a little bit to the left so it can give us a little bit more room, because otherwise you don't want to damage your strut or anything like that. Now, there is, guys, amazing tools for disconnecting the CV axle from the transmission side. Otherwise it can cause quite a bit of damage, and you've probably seen quite a few vehicles leaking from the seal there because people pry them the wrong way. Or sometimes people even break the transmission housing because they try to pry with a bar and the CV axle shaft cannot come out. So those are the tools that we'll be using. You can find them listed in the description of the video below. Check it out. Now, on some models, guys, you have to drain the transmission fluid because it may leak out. On some, it doesn't. So we'll see how ours is. Ours is the 1.8 automatic transmission 2015 model, guys. I think it's 60-40. Something like that. So we'll go ahead, get the tools now in place, and we're going to go, guys. Okay, I'm trying to get the light going. Give me just a second now. Okay, I'm trying to situate the camera to where you can see. So on this one, it's actually a little bit of a wider gap there for that too, so you might use a slatch. Okay, we have all of them listed in the description of the video below. Okay, and you're going to pry it, okay, and pop it loose, guys. Once it goes in, okay, you're going to pry and pop it loose. But this one is quite a bit of a gap, so a sledgehammer will work way better, the one with the way that you pull them. Okay, so we're going to... Okay, it came out, guys, right there. It came out, and we're not leaking transmission fluid on our model, so that is great. Now all we have to do, just grab it, guys, and gently pull it out. If you guys need to buy a new CV axle shafts, check out the link in the description of the video below, guys. You can get them for a super good price, fast shipping, guys, price that you can rarely beat. So the passenger side is very long, driver side is very short, so that's how you guys do it. Pretty much the other side is the same way as this one. Thank you guys for watching. Please subscribe to our channel for more videos, and see you guys next time.